have no clue why I'm doing this to myself.
So, Rent a Girlfriend, one of the most infamous series in recent anime history because of how shit it is. I actually could not think of any other way to describe this thing. As someone who hasn't really watched anime or read too much manga recently, I decided to head back into it by reading every single chapter of this series.
I do not know why I'm doing this to myself.
A bit of clickbait right there, I'm not actually reading every chapter of this series because I actually used to read it. According to my anime list account, if I actually recorded the progress correctly, I stopped on chapter 214, and the series currently has 330 chapters. 330 chapters. And guess what? Within these 100 chapters or so, there probably still isn't any progression to the story. Leave a like for Andy if you feel bad for him. But yeah, let's begin with chapter 215. Okay, well, honestly, off to a pretty good start. This chapter was really interesting. It's about the backstory of Mami, you know, her growing up, what she experienced, what made her become this antagonist that she is today due to, you know, her family and how controlling they are with, like, her whole entire life, basically. But what the fuck is this? Is this, like, a reference that I don't get or something? Okay, so she's basically saying she doesn't believe in love. And she thinks that everyone that says they're in love, they play, you know, play make-believe. Every single one of them. Oh my god, it turns out I didn't keep up with the progression because I've already read this whole fucking arc. Okay, now we're currently on chapter 263, The Girlfriend in the Bathroom. I think this was the arc where the apartment, what the fuck are the names again? I honestly forgot to catch these names too. With Kazuya, Chizuru, and what's the other girl's name? Meaning when their apartment was like taken down, just broken down or something, and ended up moving in together. Don't ask me why that happened. That's just what happened in the story. I stopped around here. I've definitely read some of it, but I did stop around here. So I'm just gonna continue off of here, which is honestly a good thing. We skipped around 50 chapters that I thankfully remembered reading.
Let me demonstrate how to use a song in your video, even when it's copyrighted.
That was an okay chapter, I guess. You know, Mommy's World is interesting, but they always end up doing something that just ends up ruining it. So yeah,
wow.
For the time. Ladies and gentlemen, that skill has been returned. Now I would say 264 is a better chapter than 263. We got to see Mami's like internal thoughts, her getting backflashes on what happened between her and Mizuhara and, you know, Kazuha, the conversations they had together. And we also got a shot of Subi, who I honestly do remember seeing like post chapter 200. So that was cool. Five out of 10. You guys thought we were done, huh? We do the old piece well, except to the ADE as well, you know, the one where Kazuha is jacked. 2 out of 10. They're doing the thing again where, like, Kazuha and Mizuha, they obviously like each other, they obviously are important to each other's life, but again, it's like the internal thoughts coming in, like, oh, maybe I'm not that important to them, oh, maybe I'm not. You know, they do this, like, every other fucking chapter. Actually, I'll push it up to it, because you guys show me it. Wait, is this even Japanese?
Just coming right here, perfectly represents our feeling right now. One out of 10.
Oh, this panel was pretty cute right here. You know, Mizuhara can entry before, and then Sumi, who is overly shy, even more shy than she normally is. I suddenly feel a bit more lively now. Shit, I can't wait to date this woman. Can fucking ask her out, bro. We've been waiting for 200, almost 300 chapters now.
Okay, can we talk about this real quick? Like, I know this case is, like, you know, we will not see this in real life. This is like really unrealistic, you know. But let's just say you, your crush, and one of your acquaintances, you all three of you live together, and then your crush has an upcoming birthday. Would you not get her a gift? I sort of get it. Like, you have a crush in this girl, you're really shy about it, even know if you're gonna hold a birthday party or not. But like, granted, you guys are close. You guys made a whole movie together. You guys used to be neighbors. Like, isn't it just normal to at least prepare something? I know he got the cake, but like, a present of the sort. Like, why are you freaking out over the fact that the other two people in the room got her something and the fact that you didn't? And now he has to go find something. Like, is it that hard to get something beforehand for this girl? Oh my god. Look at Mizuhara being such an understanding girl, man. He does not deserve her. Put me in the situation. I give that chapter a negative pile of 10. Why do you have to be so fucking horny?
Okay, common sense, right? You know, two of the opposing genders are put into a situation like this. I would say it's actually not normal if your heart stays at the regular rate in a situation like this. Like, if you have the opposing gender leaning up against you like that, yeah, you're gonna feel some type of way. But no, when it comes to Kazuha, his mind immediately goes to this. Someone please put that one doors meme on the screen right now. You know the funny part is, I've been rewatching Trash Taste recently. I think in one of the earlier episodes, like it was like episode 14 or 15, called like the most boring anime or whatever. Gon and Connor talked about how Kazuha is like this, you know, shitty character right now, this fucking dumbass at the moment. But they guarantee that there will be character development in the manga, and especially in the future. Fast forward for 4 years and basically nothing has changed. Oh my god, this man is legit freaking about everything she does. It's like, oh, she's standing up, she's so cute. She's sitting down, she's so cute. She wants Mapo Tofu, oh my god. Wait, what does this say? The dream life is now at the turning point and the feelings continue to grow. He will fight with all his might with renewed determination.
What the fuck does that even mean?
He made a promise that he will confess by the time he moves out. I hardly believe that statement, but let's give him a bit of a chance.
A few moments later.
I can't handle this anymore.
I actually cannot handle this anymore.
This title is pretty cool though. Like obviously, you know, it's his imaginations. Despite the fact that he's like overly obsessed with Chizuru right now, he cannot think of anything outside of her. But just like visual wise, this is like pretty neat to look at. Minnie is honestly a W wingman though. Like she's trying her hardest to make them become a thing, but you know, it's just not happening. Wait, how long has this guy been a story? I'm pretty sure he was able to do this in less than 100 chapters. You, this guy mentioned, you be handsome, rich, well-groomed, well-dressed, single, ambitious, well-spoken, confident, and clear about his feelings. Kazuya, chronic masturbator, broke, slob, has a girlfriend already that he ignores, wishy-washy, can't form a coherent sentence, awkward as hell, unreliable, needs a teenage girl to teach him how to be a man, combs his pants over every cell in your body, eardrops on your conversation like a creep. Oh my god, season 3 of Had a Girlfriend? I haven't even finished season 2. I watched one episode season 2 and I was like, okay, I don't know if I even want to do this anymore, but yeah, I'm reading the manga. Well, this could be like taking out the context like crazy. This side of the song is pretty cool though. We saw Kazuya just, you know, hang out with the kids, play with them. Gotta see him in the bright light and choose also what this reminds him. Oh my god, I know I'm shit reading this manga, but this comment is just so true. Shit like this get continually translated, but there's so many gems I care about that die off. I was going through some mangas I read from like a few years ago, right? And I obviously wanted to catch up with them, so I searched up like, you know, how many chapters are officially translated now. And a lot of them has not been translated over 2 years. But we have 300-ish chapters of Rent a Girlfriend. Okay, I've been reading this for an hour and a half, and I think this is a good stopping point for now.
It's almost 1 p.m. now, and I'm gonna go to the gym for like an hour and a half and come back and finish this thing. Yeah.
But yeah, see you guys in a bit. Holy shit, the camera's like really like overheated right now. It's been around 3 hours since I first left, but I think it's honestly impressive that I even came back to read it. Not gonna lie, let's get this the fuck out of the way because I have actual stuff to do, so let's speedrun these last 20 chapters. I'm tired though. It's 11:40 p.m. I don't know why I'm doing this time. Hopefully my landlord doesn't even hear me right now. He's probably asleep by this point, but hopefully no one hears me right now. This whole song is actually pretty cute. They have Chizuru in like a chibi form because, you know, she's on appearance, she isn't feeling the greatest. And it's honestly adorable. Now this is true character development right here. From whatever chapter we started from, this is probably like the nicest thing. The only like actual nice thing this man has done so far. Oh, I was about to say, like towards the end of the last chapter, chapter 307, we heard that Chizuru is going on a date as a rental girlfriend again. I was like, okay, that's kind of weird. But it turns out to be Kazuya's grandma that rented her out. Did not expect this, and this is actually like pretty good for the story. This was honestly pretty wholesome, and we saw you know who towards the end. Mommy being at the arcade herself though. You know, like I used to hate mom as a character, especially in the anime. But I feel like after learning her backstory, I can understand her a bit better now, and it's probably because of the fact that I haven't been keeping up this series in so long. I don't really care. I don't really have that much hate for her anymore. So I'm actually just like, you know, slightly worried. Like, what is she doing at the arcades by herself? Ooh, that's actually a very good outfit right there. I think there's a figurine of her wearing this exact outfit. Something similar to it. Okay, I'm gonna scroll down. If I see like some perverters, some zoom-ins within the next 3 panels, I am leaving. We need to start doing better, bro. Please stop with this shit.
Wow, he did something.
This is gonna sound really fucked up, but like, you know that feeling where you feel so pitiful about something that like any single improvement they have, you're like genuinely proud of. That's how I feel about this game, actually.
This is okay. A solid day plan, lunch, and I joy potters. I think that's the place you want to assume a Chinese hot pot and talk at the park. Just have a walk around when it's dark, no one's around, you know, like walk off the food that you just ate. Okay.
Actually, I think this means something right here, right? Because on the day they go on the date, May 17th, it's gonna rain. In one of the previous chapters, Shizu said that whenever she goes on a date with Kazuya, whenever, you know, he went to the island or whatever, the weather was always nice. But for this specific date, it's gonna rain, so, you know, I feel like that does mean something right there.
Okay, we're finally on the last chapter, the last updated chapter. 3:30.
Right here, Chizuru went out for a massage in preparation for this day. I think this is the day before. Kazuya's out shopping together, you know, half decent outfit. Like, this man actually has no drip at all. She cares about how her hair looks to him. That's good. That's a good sign for our boy. Is he even our boy? I don't know. Like, depending on how he does on this day. Talk to Martins? Wait. Ooh, these could work with like specific outfits. I don't know if it's his style though. Unless he pulls off like, a crazy fit out of here.
Yeah, we're in right here. Nothing much really happened in this chapter. You know, Kazuya got new shoes. Chizu has some internal thoughts or seeing Kazuya out, thinking that, you know, he's probably out to get out for the date, which he felt kind of special about.
We ended off on an okay note, I guess. Like, okay for him. But yeah, it's almost 5 p.m. now. I wasted like 3 hours of my day reading this shit. As a whole, I think this experience was like a 4 out of 10. Like, I didn't completely hate it, but would I do it again? Like, don't ask me that shit. So, that question I asked before we started reading this. Has the story made any progression at all? And if I had to be honest, not trying to make fun of the series or anything, I would say yes. Which is funny because if these last 10 chapters didn't exist, the progression would be non-existent. But he did just sit up as Shizu out on a date, which is a lot. And he also confirmed like, hey, you know, I know that you're still concerning your feelings for me. So you're just trying to find out how you actually feel. So let's go on this date, this official date, so we can get to know each other better and also, you know, help her figure out her feelings. That part was honestly quite important. It did contribute a lot to the story. Like, if you asked me beforehand, like, when the story ends, I would have no fucking clue. But after seeing this, I have confidence that we could be done with chapter 400.
But yeah, I do not feel good about myself after reading this shit. So I'ma go take a shower now to wash off all of the dirt, all of the horniness, and the low IQ shit that this man should have passed on to us.
But yeah, that's it for this video. If you guys enjoyed it, feel free to like, comment, maybe subscribe. If you're actually doing anything, then you're not doing quite anything. If you'd like to help me out, you should like the
main series. This is like the second manga that I have read since my return to like anime slash otaku culture. And do I regret it? Kind of, but at the same time, like, if I can read this, if I can read 100 chapters of this in a single day, I feel confident I can actually like read and binge any series that's actually like half decent now. But that's all again for me today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Hopefully you guys will have a nice day, and hopefully we will see each other again. I'm actually tired from reading this. I don't know why. Sorry for wasting not only my but your guys' time today, but I'm gonna go take this shower now. Peace out.